Do subscribe to IIT-JEE channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT-JEE main and advanced videos.
Students, today we'll discuss about another physics paper, JEE mains physics 2014. So let us discuss all those questions one by one. Okay.
Students, let us move to the next question. The question is, in a large building, there are 15 bulbs of 40 watt each, 5 bulbs of 100 watt and 5 fans of 80 watt and a heater of 1 kilowatt. The voltage of the electric mains is 220 volt. The minimum capacity of the main fuse of the building will be the minimum capacity of the main fuse. What is the meaning of this main fuse? Actually, you have to look for the current that can flow through the fuse wire. You must have idea that in any building there must be a fuse, or in any room also, individual rooms. And in our household room also, and there is a fuse which if short circuit or if the current is large enough, that which is not desirable, which is, that means more than the capacity of the current that flows through the circuit to your building, then it will trip down or the fuse will burn. So it is there to prevent any damage to the person and to protect us. The fuse is there, and the main capacity you have to find. That means you have to actually find the current that is passing through the fuse. To find that, what you have to do? So you have got 15 volts, so you have to find the current drawn by each of these elements connected, and see how much a bulb will draw, and there are 15 bulbs, so total how much current it will draw. Similarly, you have to find a check for each and every one. And we know that in a building the connections are parallel connections, so you have to find the power in parallel connections, how much is the total power. And we also know that in parallel connections of resistance, the powers are added in series. So, in series form. So, let us find that. Firstly, there are the formula for power is V square by R. And also, it is I square R. I square R, and also VI. So there are the three formulae. So we'll use this formula because the potential difference, the voltage, is constant in parallel connections. Whatever is constant, that formula you'll use. So in parallel connection, the voltage is constant. So V is constant, means power is inversely proportional to resistance. This one I'll use. Okay. Now, to find the resistance of each bulb, because the rating of a bulb, if you think of a bulb, the rating is 40 watt and the supply is 220 volt. Supply is 220. So this is volt. So the resistance is found by resistance is V square by the power. The voltage supply is 220, so 220 divided by power is 40 watt. This is the resistance of the single bulb. Similarly, we have to find the resistance of each of the element. Now let us find the resistance, and the power, effective power, the total power, P total is P1 plus P2. P1 I am using for 40 watt bulb, P2 I am using for 100 watt bulb, 5 bulbs together I will write this, plus for fan I will write P3 and for heater I will write P4. So the total power consumption is this. But then power is V square by R. So this is R1 like this, V square by R1. But then R1 is the, for this ball this is R1 value. So I'll write the formula, then we'll solve. This is V square by R2 plus V square by R3 and V square by R4. And here it is V square by R effective or R equivalent. This P total is also this. Now the voltage is same for each of the element because it is in parallel connection, voltage will be same, and only this is the thing. Now you have to find the, put the values of and we have to find the current that is responsible for this. So finally you have to find the current. So P is equal to V into I, equation will use, and from that P equals to V into I, we'll find what is I, is the P by V, then P total by V, that is total power that is consumed divided by the supply voltage. So this formula we are going to use, but then you have to find the P total. So to find P total, what we have is that P total is P1, that is V square by R1. And there are how many bulbs, because V square by R1 is the power, V square by R1 into how many bulbs are there. There are 15 bulbs, so 15 into this is how much, for V square by R. So it is what is the use of getting this? I'll first write this 40 watt plus I'll make it 5 into 100 watt plus 5 into 80 plus 1 into 1000. One heater is there, 1000. So the total power comes out to be 1 by R equivalent. So P1, P2, this is 15 for the 60. So 600 plus 500 plus 400 plus 1000. This comes out to be 2500. What total power is this? So the current is 2500 divided by 220. Okay, 220. So 2500 to 2520 volts goes. So this is 2550 divided by 22. This is 125 divided by 11. So that comes out to be 125 by 11. That comes out to be, if it is 10, it is 12.5. Let us have a rough calculation, because our answer is, if you see the options, then it is 8, 10, 12, and 14, whichever is nearer the round of figure. So if I use R equals to, suppose this one, this I will use as 125 divided by 11, if I use a rough calculation, then it is 125 divided by 10, then it is 12.5. If you take 10, it is 12.5, and if you take little more than 10, this value will be little less than 12.5. So it will be around 12. If you solve it, then also you get around 12. So approximately this is 12 amps. So therefore, if you see the options, the correct answer to this is 12 amps. So what we have done is basically to find the total power drawn by all the elements, and because they are connected in parallels, so you have to find the total power, and the power if they are in parallel, that is, then you have to add all the powers P1, P2, P3 and all, then use the formula P equals to VI. From that you get I equals to P by V. So total power divided by the voltage that supplied 220, and you will get an answer. Okay, thank you.